everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we're going to tell you what you can do with squash.
I can tell you what to do with squash.
Shh. You know how at the end of summer, or maybe even starting in the middle of summer, suddenly you have more squash than you can possibly think of what to do with it. You give it to your neighbors, they hide when they see you coming. Now we have some ideas that you can use that will help you use the squash, not only right now, but also come winter time.
Well, I've got to tell you, you know, you've been donating a lot of squash to a lot of different organizations, and what's the first question they ask you?
What do I do with this? And we had this bush. Some of you may have seen it in a previous video.
Bush. It was a forest.
That planted itself. The year before, we had had a variety of squash in the same area. We had butternut and spaghetti and patty pan and zucchini. And we decided not to use that area this year, and instead we put some perennial flowers. Well, all of a sudden, outgrows this squash. And when they started coming ripe, they started looking like patty pans. And we thought, oh my gosh, some seed must have fallen into the soil and planted itself. And we hadn't planted any this year, so we thought, oh, that's good. Well, this seems to be an alien breed here. I think it's one of the reasons why when you try planting a hybrid seed, you get some from the mom and some from the dad and some that are mixed up.
Was it from Area 51?
These are, maybe. These are not your normal patty pan squash. They are very hard, very hard, to the point where it's hard to cut them and hard to peel them. So we had almost 300 of these little things. And even though I picked them small and I let some of them get bigger, it doesn't seem to matter. They are still very hard. And yet I don't want to just toss them away. I mean, it's a shame. So we decided we would try some things with them and see what we could do. Once I got done doing all my things with it, this is what I ended up with. And while this is very usable, you can saute these in olive oil or butter and then sprinkle them with Parmesan cheese. They're very tasty. They're a lot of work. There should be something else we could do with them, and that's what we're going to do today. I'm going to try very hard not to cut my fingers off while I'm doing this, just so you can see what it takes to get this thing open. So I'm going to try to cut a bottom off so I have a flat surface to work in.
Yes, please be careful with your hands.
Okay, so far so good. At least now it's stable. Now I can try cutting it like this, and yes, I could do it.
I like chopping wood.
But I will be like Julia Child.
Julia!
Okay, everyone, here I go. Wow, smack right into the stem. There. Okay.
Now when you do that, make sure your hand is nowhere near.
Exactly. So now you see there's seeds. Well, best way to get them out, and this is great, is if you have a grapefruit spoon and you just scoop them out. That comes out easily, leaves that whole nice area. Then you have to peel it. I have tried my heavy-duty peeler trying to peel this, and it's like trying to peel a bowling ball. It just doesn't work. So the next thing I had to do...
Do you peel a lot of bowling balls?
...is cut it up into a smaller piece without taking my hand off, and then peeling it with a paring knife. I mean, this is a lot of work to go through for these little squash. Finally.
So you're always going to have tiny little pieces?
You're always going to have tiny pieces. Now, we tried earlier, we were going to use this fantastic food grater system that is available on the market.
What do they call this?
This is a salad master.
Salad master.
Food processor. Okay, and it comes with different blades that you can use to do shredding. Put it in there. And you can see how it's going to twirl. Now, we tried doing one with the skin on just to see if the skin would be palatable enough to use, and it really wasn't. And I don't particularly want to hold my hand here while I do this because this is extremely sharp. So there is a fantastic part that you can just put the pieces in and hold this down. Okay, now I do see I have some bigger pieces, which I'm guessing I can just put in another way or with some more.
That's kind of a finger guard, right?
Yes, definitely. And it makes it very safe for you to use. Even this, I think my pieces are just maybe too small when I started them. Now, this is a lot of work to go through just to get shredded squash. What am I going to do with it? I can add some egg, maybe some breadcrumbs, or if you want to go gluten-free, don't use bread, but you can put in shredded cheese, form them into little patties, fry them or bake them in olive oil, and use them like you would hash browns. That's one way. You could cook them up a little bit and use it under a spaghetti squash instead of using under spaghetti sauce instead of using a wheat noodle, let's say. You can freeze this, and then at a later date you could make zucchini bread, but it wouldn't be zucchini. It would be like a squash bread or a squash cake, where you would use a zucchini recipe, but instead use a different kind of squash. So these are different options that you have.
Well, can't you freeze them?
Yes, you can freeze them. And you don't need to blanch it. You just measure out what you know your recipe is going to call for, like 2 cups or whatever. Put it into a freezer plastic bag. And then flatten it out so that when you want to use it, it's not in one big chunk. It's flattened out and it'll thaw nicely. And then use that. But if you've pre-measured it, it's so much easier and you're not wasting anything. So this is one kind of squash to use. We are also going to be shredding up.
How do you clear that?
Oh, you put your hand in the inside.
Other way.
And then you just pull it out.
Yeah, because you don't want to do it the other way or you end up shredding your fingers.
But this is what it looks like. Take out the big chunks, obviously. But this is very helpful, very tasty, and it's just this particular kind of squash is a difficult squash to work with.
It's kind of like sauerkraut, too. I wonder if you could pickle it.
Well, sure. I suppose you could. But, you'd have to try it. You'd have to see if you could find a recipe that somebody has maybe used or make up your own.
See, I wanted you to shred these to a size where they were like French fries, and then you could roll it in eggs and then maybe roll it in something, rice flour if you want a gluten-free thing,
right.
And then bake them or fry them or whatever.
You could, but not with this particular squash.
No. Well, this was very difficult squash to work with. I can tell you, just watching you try to do this, was painful.
Yes, it was.
Now, I'm sure with a...
Thank goodness I still have all my fingers.
Yeah, I'm sure with a real patty pan squash or something,
yes,
it would have
been much easier.
Heck of a lot easier rather than these alien squash.
Exactly. As I said, if you're going to freeze it, which is a very good option, and this squash, I don't want to belittle this squash because it is a very flavorful and actually kind of a sweet squash. But what you want to do It's very tasty. To me, it's more tasty than zucchini. Is measure. And I know a lot of the recipes that I've seen for zucchini bread or zucchini cake calls for 2 cups. So what you're going to do is just measure ahead of time. So you've taken that wastefulness out of it. Mark your bag. We're going to call these vajoodles. And dump your squash in there. Close it up. Get the air out of it. And then move it around, flatten it out so that when you want to thaw it out, it's not going to take forever. In fact, you could take this bag and when you're ready to use it, put it in a bowl with warm water, put another warm bowl over the top with warm water, and it'll thaw out in a matter of minutes.
Well, the other thing nice about having it flat is you can stack them easily
sure.
in a freezer.
Very much so, yes. After conferring with a couple of friends as to, you know, how this would be made easier to work with, they suggested that we poke a couple of holes in and put it in the microwave just to soften it up a little bit so that it would be more workable. I'm going to try it for 2 minutes. I don't want to cook it so it's all soft and squishy. I just want to make it workable so I can actually cut into it. Okay, let's see what we have. Well, we have some juice coming out of the top. It feels warm. Well, let's see what happens over here. Yep, it's definitely warm. Let's see if I can cut the back off.
Any easier?
Yes, seems a little bit easier. But now it's hot. Let me try this.
Ah, look at that.
Look at that.
So now is it mushy?
No. Mm-mm.
So you could go longer than 2 minutes.
I probably could. I probably could.
And it's ready to eat.
Not quite.
Oh.
No, it's still has a firmness to it where we could still grind it up or shred it.
Hmm.
It's kind of like
a pumpkin.
That's a
good idea to heat it up or microwave it.
Mm-hmm. Now it's the peeling part also that makes it difficult.
And that's why you quarter it or cut it in 8, because I know you can't even take the peel off with a quartering by quartering it.
Right. Okay, it's definitely easier. It could have gone a little bit longer. It's still a little bit difficult, but you can hear the hardness of this skin. It's like a big pumpkin, almost.
It has that pumpkin skin quality
mm-hmm,
to it?
Yes. So it would be another option, especially if you just wanted to use them to eat and to prepare for use right now. But let's try a different kind of squash and see what other kinds of shredding we could do. Okay, let's go back to a very favorite squash, one that's quite common, and that's your major zucchini squash. Okay, much easier to cut. And since it is such a wide squash, this one in particular, I am just going to cut it down halfway. Okay, and then you can see we don't want to be eating these seeds. They're too big. If you had small zucchinis with really tiny seeds, you could use the seed part. You wouldn't have to take them out.
Now, you could dry those seeds too, right? And save them?
Depending on if this were a
heirloom.
An heirloom zucchini. There are so many different kinds of zucchinis out now, bush zucchinis and a whole variety, that you'd want to be sure that it was a hybrid and not a, a heirloom and not a hybrid.
Otherwise you have an alien?
You would, and who knows what that would look like.
That might be fun during Halloween, though.
Okay, so once all the seeds are out, we'll be ready to put it through our shredder.
Now, are you going to shred it with the skin on?
I think I am, yes.
Okay, because I know the skin oftentimes has the healthy goodies.
Yes, it's a nice skin. It doesn't have any spots on it that bother me. So, yes, I am. I may actually cut it down once more. Seems that the middle is out.
Maybe try cutting this one down in half first and see what happens.
Okay. Well, let me get these seeds out. Now I've used the waffle slicer part of this machine here. Getting a variety of shapes here. Let me just stop and show you some of the bigger shapes. So these are a good size that you could use for different things. And then the smaller pieces you could either put into a salad and eat raw, topped with your favorite salad dressing. Or again, you could use it as part of a vegetable that you're going to be cooking or steaming, and those little pieces would kind of just blend right in.
So what kind of things can you do with these waffle or slices?
Well, we've been talking about that, and you could just put them on a baking sheet, spray it with a nonstick spray, put them on a baking sheet, spray them with olive oil, and put your favorite seasoning on it. Lowry's would be good, a seasoned salt, or just plain salt and pepper.
Okay.
Another thing you could do, and we're going to be trying this afternoon, is to take them and put them in the dehydrator. Now, in order to do that, I'm going to spray this dehydrator sheet first, because I have a feeling they may stick. So I'm just going to spray this lightly and then put these on. What I'm doing is I'm looking for pieces that are about the same size and the same thickness so that they will all dry evenly once they're in the dehydrator.
Now, would you soak these in a solution before actually putting them on the sheet? I mean, if you want them to have a saltier flavor, would you put them in a salt brine or mixer?
Well, you could do that, but I think if we just sprinkle them with salt right here, that should be enough. You could also sprinkle them with seasonings, oregano, or any kind of herb that you would like. And because they are moist already, I think it'll stick to it. So I'm just going to sprinkle it with Lowry salt. And then we'll put these in the dehydrator, and they should come out nice and crispy and be very tasty, very healthful. Into the dehydrator they go.
And how long would you, because these are pretty thin.
They are very thin, yes. Well, probably I'd start out with 30 minutes at probably 135 and see how that works. If you're going to do it in your oven, remember you're going to have it at the lowest temperature your oven will go in, and then you just kind of have to keep checking them and until they are as dry as you think you want them. You may have to taste them every now and again to see if they are.
And of course, once they're dry, you just put them in a nice sterilized jar to keep them?
Unless
or
they
use
are
them
gone
right away?
Just like that, and you don't
like
have any to put away.
Ah.
Now I'm going to do the good old standby shredding zucchini for zucchini bread, zucchini cake. And you can see this is an excellent, excellent thing for shredding. It does an excellent job.
Now I noticed you had the skin.
Put the skin
aimed,
side
right.
toward the, oh, look at this. That's interesting.
Oh.
A whole part that was up against the edge. But I thought it would work better if I put the skin toward the actual grater.
That works really well, and I like the color combination too.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, the skin has the healthy goodies.
As long as it's clean. Okay, then what you need to do again is measure it out. 2 cups usually. You have to check your favorite recipe ahead of time so you know how big. And then put it in your pre-marked bag. We're going to call these zoodles. Okay. Let's take the air out. And then flatten it out. There you go. Put the date, you know how old they are, and then the rest you can make into zucchini cake today. Now there are other things that you can do with zucchini also. You can not only make bread and cake and put them in your dehydrator, but you can also make what we call zucchini candy. And it's in one of our former videos. Perhaps you'd like to look at it. There's also a version called adult zucchini candy. So it might be fun for you to look at that. Many people like to use zucchini fresh in their salads. Again, that's something you can use any kind of squash for. Just be sure it's at its best peak. Don't try to use one that's too old or too woody. Yes, sometimes the bigger they get, you know, they do get a woody texture to them.
Now, you made zucchini cookies and bread?
Yes, you can make all of those. And the kids won't mind it at all. They won't even taste it. There's a chocolate zucchini cake and the recipes on different YouTube videos that... It's wonderful. It's a very moist cake, and it's just delicious.
So, what was the question I was going to ask you?
Where do I find zucchini candy?
Oh, recipes? That's right.
Yes. Go to our website, wisconsingarden.com. Right under the title, you will see videos by topic.
A through Z.
A through Z. And you're going to have to scroll down because zucchini starts with a Z. It'll be down near the bottom of that particular scene.
Well, I think it's a perfect time too because Halloween is coming, and what is so cool is you can create all these different shapes out of zucchini using cookie cutters
right.
and all kinds
just
of goodies.
Cut it into little slices.
Yep.
And
the kids will never know what healthy things they are eating.
They're very much like gummy candy.
Gummy bears.
Right.
Yeah.
Now from that zucchini that you saw, that one large piece of zucchini, we got 4 packages, 2 cups each. And then this was our other one made out of these little white ones. These are ready to go into the freezer and be ready for any kind of zucchini or squash delight that you have and you want to make into something else. Next, we're going to talk about butternut squash. Butternut squash is a very sweet squash. It's a winter squash, which means, again, it has a hard shell on it. And oftentimes people like to bake it because it just brings out the sweet, creamy flavor to it. Again, because it is hard, you have to carefully give yourself some flat areas to work on. Okay, so the top is done.
That looks really nice, doesn't
it? It is, yes. Mm. One of my favorites. And then cut off the bottom.
Now, we should have brought some of our Zeppelin, delicata Zeppelin squash, too.
Oh, yes, we should have. Mm-hmm.
But.
Okay, and you see that there's going to be seeds. The interesting thing about butternut squash is the seeds are all in this part. You're not going to have any seeds in this part. So that makes it fun. And this one, I am usually able to peel. It has a softer peel. Okay, and you can do this while it's whole like this, or you could, if you want, cut the two different parts. If you have a really big one, cut it here, and then do the two sections separately, just to make it easier for you to peel. Okay, make sure you got all of that skin off, because that's not tasty, and I don't think it's very nutritious either. Once that's done, I will cut it this way. See, no seeds in the top part.
So then this one you just cut in half to scoop out the seeds?
Yes.
Okay.
Or quarter. These are more like pumpkin seeds. You can see the, not the size of them, but the stringy part that's in there that you always have to pull out by your hands. The part that always makes you go, ew, and it almost smells like pumpkin.
Now, the spoon you're using has little teeth on the edge, right?
Yes, it's a grapefruit spoon.
Okay.
Now, this is an heirloom squash, so you could keep these seeds and plant these seeds. If you have a compost bin, you may not want to put these seeds into it because they will grow.
And you'll have plenty of plants for next year, right?
You will, and they'll take over. Once you have your butternut squash cut up, and I usually like to cube mine, even smaller than this. I don't usually put mine in the oven. I usually just cut it up into small pieces. Show you how small. Then I put them in the microwave and cook them for about, cover it with, you know, put a cover of wax paper, or if you have some kind of cover, microwave cover. Put them in the microwave, start at about 3 minutes, and then test it with a fork, see if it's soft. See if it would be an edible consistency. And then I take them out. For Rick, I just put butter on them, and he likes to eat them that way. I like to put a little bit of brown sugar and butter and a little bit of honey on mine, and sometimes nutmeg. And I like to mash mine up. More like a
potatoes?
Sweet potato.
Sweet,
right.
Potato.
More like a sweet potato. And they have a very similar taste and a similar texture.
Now, if you were going to put this in a salad and to eat right away, would you have to cook it first?
Let me see. Yep.
It's like a carrot?
Kind of like a carrot.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I would think so. Well, there are so many other things that obviously you can with a, what do you call that, a salad?
Salad master shredder.
Salad master shredder, mm-hmm.
It's a very handy tool.
Yep.
And we thank our daughter for letting us use her kitchen and her microwave and her dehydrator and her oven. and also clean everything up for us.
Oh, that's nice.
It's a real treat. If you enjoyed this video and maybe gave you some ideas of what you can do with squash, and there's many different kinds of squash we didn't even talk about. There's a Hubbard squash, which is a big, bumpy purple one. There's the delicata squash, which is the little ovally shaped one that has stripes on it.
Looks like a Green Bay Packer football.
That Rick just loves. And this year we grew that pink banana squash that we haven't quite figured out what to do with it, or if it's more like a butternut squash. So we'll be doing some experimenting, and we hope we gave you some ideas too. If you'd like to give us a thumbs up, we'd love it. If you'd like to ask a question or send a comment, that would be a wonderful thing also. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, please hit this little subscribe button right over here. Thanks for watching.
Connect with us on YouTube.